What's up, guys? Okay, last week was crazy because it was really crazy. I did not upload a video. I lost my files. I felt down after that moment, but thanks to you guys, those of you that follow me on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, you guys were there, you know, to cheer me up, and I appreciate that so much. It means a lot to me. I mean, you're putting much work into something, and all of a sudden you lost the fires. You know how painful that could be. Like, I put a lot of work into that, and it's just unfortunate that I lost it. Yeah, it's fine now. Yeah, I'm feeling okay. I'm feeling better now. And what's up with our team? I mean, England versus Nigeria. Why would we lose to England? It's not like England is that hard. Seriously, I mean, what are they looking? What are they doing on the pitch? Are they just there to advertise their beautiful jersey by Nike? Come on, Nigeria, we need to wake up. The team, we need to wake up, okay? Russia is here. We need to win that cup, okay? Even though it's not, we think it's not possible. It might be possible. I think this is possible anyways. What do you think about that match? Just let me know. Do you think they're ready for it, or they're just there to advertise their jersey that cost 41,000? Their jersey that cost 41,000 naira. Okay, guys, welcome to my channel. That being said, guys, let's check out this advert. I like this Pepsi advert. And if you get it, you got the Niger spirit. This Niger spirit, we breathe it. Best believe it, real as my heartbeat is. The Niger spirit, you can't beat it. So even when I lose, I am not defeated. We all breathe it, we all bleed it, we all live it. The Niger spirit, Niger all the way.
Niger all the way.
I stumbled on this on Niraland, and the name of this person is, or the username on Niraland is IP Africa Staff, and he said letter to Olamide. Why Olamide shouldn't release an album this year, 2018? And what this guy was trying to say is that Olamide keeps releasing album like every year, like yearly. He hasn't released any album in 2018, but what this guy's trying to say is that Olamide should cool down, chill before he puts out an album. It started out by praising Olamide, but along the line, he started, you know, blasting Olamide. He said the wax song or lack of content albums started in 2015 with Enyo Mayweather. Let me take this. While you've established as a legend in the game for over 7 years now, it's saddening to see the quality of your output album reduced year after year. It started with Enyo Mayweather. We saw another Olamide that was at an all-time low. So many records that wasn't worth listening to. Imagine going to Alaba to purchase. You're going to Alaba to purchase a bootleg CD, okay? An already hyped album. I felt Enyo Mayweather was rushed to meet the deadline. Let me know what you think about this in the comment section below. Do you think Olamide should put out an album this year? Because Olamide has always been that guy that love to meet up with a deadline. I think there was, in 2015 he released two albums, like Enyo Mayweather and Two Kings in 2015. I don't know if Two Kings was an EP or something. He started up by Goodnight Rhapsody in 2011, YBNL in 2012. I'm talking about the album right now. 2013, Baddest Guy Ever Leave It. 2014, Straight O2. 2015, Two Kings and Enyo Mayweather. And 2016, The Glory. 2017, Lagos Nawa. Now 2018, we don't know yet. I think Olamide should give it time before he put out an album. If you look at it closely, you would notice that Wizkid has only released, I think, 3 albums and 1 EP. Superstar in 2011, in 2014, Ayo, in 2017, Sounds from the Other Side. And we're still talking about Wizkid today. So the albums he put out doesn't guarantee the longevity. I'm just saying though, I think Davido has like two albums. Omobawalu was in 2012, and in 2015 I think he put out an album as well. We're still talking about Davido is still getting shows, so I think Olamide should look for another strategy, but that is up to you guys. Let me know what you think about that in the comment section below. Yeah, we have Yemi Alade. Yemi Alade journey just hit 90 million views on YouTube. That was the song that brought her to limelight. And yeah, so congratulations to Yemi Alade. You give you
Kem Kedi Feneme. Johnny Mo, Johnny Mo, I'm looking for my Johnny. Where is my Johnny? Johnny Mo.
Now, speaking about Wizkid, Wizkid got a new album coming up. It's called Made in Lagos. Yeah, I was supposed to talk about this last week, but I lost the files, so I need to talk about it today. It's very, very important. Okay, he said that the song has 10 tracks. He said no features. It's just Wizkid 100%. He has no features on them. It was interviewed by Team Westwood in London.
Big love, man. New album coming soon. Wizkid, new stuff.
So what's the story with the new album, man? Because you normally break off later.
The new album is called Made in Lagos.
Right.
Wizkid, Made in Lagos. That's all. 10 tracks. No features. Straight Wizkid.
And that's what you are, Made in Lagos, baby.
Yeah, Made in Lagos.
Now, you ever wondered why Wizkid don't really like to feature other artists? Well, this might seem like pride to some people, but I don't think it's pride. I just think that Starboy, you know, believe in himself. That's what I think. If you look at it, like, after the first album dropped June 12, 2011, which it features like various Nigerian artists, where I was on that Banky W, which I still call the best album that Wizkid has ever released. The number of features began to drop, okay? And that was one thing I noticed about Wizkid. He released the second album, Ayo, on the September 17th, 2014, which features only few Nigerian artists. It began to drop, okay? And more producers, producers like Sars, Shizzy, there'll be Dr. Fraps, Malik Berry, and all. Now he said he's not gonna feature like anybody on his new album. I'm not surprised though, I've seen that coming. Okay, Wizkid later sent a subtle message to The Weeknd, okay, the Canadian singer, who also has a song and an album titled Starboy, okay? So Wizkid says there's only one Starboy, okay? Only one Starboy.
Look what you done. I'm a motherfucking Starboy. Look what you done.
Come on, Starboy, man. Only one Starboy. You hear that? One Starboy. Love.
Yeah, as a Nigerian, of course, I'm going to support Wizkid. Yeah, there's only one Starboy. Okay, guys, moving on to the next news. Someone sent me this, okay, on Facebook. He reached out to me on Instagram. Then I asked him to send me the video on Facebook. It's about Tekno, Danfo Driver. And this guy, Professor Linkin, he has a song back then, Jogodo. For some of you might not know, it's an Ajegunle breed. But this guy also has a song titled Jogodo. He was being interviewed and they said Danfo Driver has no right. Okay, that was what he's trying to say, to challenge Tekno because they are not the original owner of the song Jogodo. But I don't know, we are going to listen to the interview. I'm going to try and quickly play like the songs, okay? So you guys could compare and tell me what you think about it.
Danfo Drivers, then go hold Tekno for Nika. Say Tekno copy their music, you know? Say Tekno copy their music, but at the end of the day, we'll come here and say they settle. But the Jogodo, we know, say, now you originate Jogodo.
Yes, sir.
Are you getting me?
Yes.
Because their own na Polongo. But we'll go play the two music. Come play techno, oh, make we come compare before we talk. Eh?
Oh, but no lepers in the whistler and the ganja. Me, I won't feel like re. I saw one they feel like re before I know. Me, I don't jugo do. That's what they say. Me, I don't jugo do. Yes, I don't jugo do. Eh, oh, I don't jugo do. Majaki and me, go.
You don't pay. Because if them won't celebrate, narrow machine out. If them won't pick in no way, come on, narrow machine out. Oh yeah, but they will every day, Nigerian down for we call them Polongo. Dance like Polongo, act like Polongo, wine like Polongo, yeah, like Polongo. I walk on a...
Narrow machine down. In the olden days, you don't take a narrow machine down. Oh, wind up, Jogodo, hey, yeah, Jogodo, oh, ma, Jogodo, school, Jogodo, Kaliyayina, Jogodo, oh, mama, Jogodo, oh, father, Jogodo, oh, nana, Jogodo, I said, oh, yeah, Jogodo, no other, Jogodo, Besha, Jogodo.
Okay, guys, so, that is it, guys. Let me know what you think about that in the comment section. below. Now, moving on to the next news, it's talking about Eniola Badmus. The actress cries out saying that celebrity housemate is a scam. During an interview with EPTV, she revealed that she said that, you know, she hasn't received a 7 million naira check as promised. Okay, the winner is meant to go home with 7 million naira. She was announced the winner, and it's been like 3 months now since the show ended.
About the money you said, I'm yet to receive my money. I'm yet to receive it. To me, I see them like a scam, but don't worry, we'll sort it out.
Guys, what is your take on this? Okay, one of the big news of the day is this man who crushes with his album, the BBN winner 2017. Do you think this is good? It is discouraging for you to do something like this. Get it on camera and post it on social media. I don't know what you guys think about this. I saw this on Insta blog Ninja. Okay, just let me know what you think in the comment section. And Tonto DK as well react to this. She said that stop cyberbullying. It's now moving on to the next one. I don't understand. I don't know. Because I'm confused right now. Is Bobrisky growing boobs? Check out this picture, guys. I know I've said that before, like Bobrisky said he's gonna grow boobs, but I thought it was joking, but this seemed like it's real and this boobs or this breast is coming to life. Okay? Whatever he's taking looks like it's working for him. I don't understand why Bobrisky decided to go this far. He said he's trying to have a cleavage, okay, and that's why he just want to do it. I would say that he should tread carefully because this is Nigeria, okay? This is Nigeria. You should be very careful. Guys, let me know what you think about this in the comment section. And now, yeah, one of the big news as well. Whiskey says, if I have sex with your girl, you won't get her back. He posted this on Sunday and people are kind of confused. Like, what is going on with Whiskey? Is Whiskey normal on a Sunday morning? You posting something like this? And someone says here, give your life to Christ. Okay, do you think Whiskey should give his life to Christ? Another person here says, it's 5 a.m. Starboy, please. Okay, guys, yeah. Davido and Whiskey make 2018 Forbes African 30 under 30 list. So congratulations to Davido and Whiskey on this. On that same list, we have Nasty C, okay? We have Casper Nasty C of South Africa. We have Sako Die of Ghana. Casper Nyovest, Fowls, Yemi Alade, Beverly Naya, and so on. So congratulations once again to all the people on the list. Right here, we have Tekno, okay? Tekno gets signed. All right, to Universal Music, they made a toast to the hustle. Let's watch.
Number one, top 100. Amen. And cheers.
That is Tekno right there celebrating his new deal with Universal Music. All right, Whiskey. And Scales finally buried the hatchet. Scales said, he posted on his page and he says, no negative vibes, only love in our heart. Whiskey, it's time, Sunday motivation, Mr. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, that is it, Scales and Whiskey. No more fight between these two. It's fine between both of them. Show or one concert that brings all African musicians together as one, and also it makes them to show each other love, whatever the fight they set to it. And I think Polukoi, not the Polukoi of P Square, but Polukoi has done well by, you know, organizing a concert like this. You know, I think it's a way to bring peace to Africa and the entertainment industry in Africa. Still at the One Africa Music Fest, Niniola performed and she looks bigger now. And yeah, she was blasted. Instead of people talking about her performance, which was excellent, she killed it as always. Niniola, as always, she has this good stage performance. But people would not stop talking about her weight. The body shaming online. Some comments here say she's pregnant. Now we have Tony Lawani and Nina. Nina celebrated her birthday a few days ago and she was gifted a car by Tony Lawani. Okay, but everyone, okay, on social media says Tony Lawani is that kind of lady that wouldn't give you anything for free. And Tony Lawani has an ulterior motive, but Tony Lawani came out to blast everyone who keeps saying that she has an ulterior motive, saying that she has helped a lot of people. And some of the superstars that we see today, she has helped a lot of them. That Nina is lucky and she has no ulterior motive about this. What do you think about that? Do you think she's doing it for money or whatever? Let me know in the comment section. Dami Crane says, I paid for all my videos even when I was under a record label. Okay, he posted this recently on his Instagram page. Bought my first Benz at 16, bought my first real estate property at 17, paid for all my videos myself even when I was under a record label. Sometimes you gotta look back and appreciate yourself. Most importantly, never give up. Youngest in charge. The funny thing is people are finding it difficult, okay, to look past his 2017 credit card theft issue. Someone here says, so you did all that by 17 and how did you make the money, sir? Inspire us with the road to success. He says here, made my first hit, my dear, at 16. Now you made your first hit at 16 and I'm trying to calculate, like, he's 26 years old. Now he released my dear in 2012. But when you calculate it, like 2012 till now, it's like 6 years, right? If you add that 6 years to 16, okay, he said he was 16 then. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. So it's gonna be 22 this year. It doesn't add up. I don't know. Maybe I don't understand what he's trying to say. But guys, let me know what you think in the comment section. The last one I'm gonna take for the day is this post by Nigerian Women Diary. Here it says, people are going under the knife to get fake but permanent dimples. The procedure is called dimpleplasty and will cost you about over 400,000 naira. Surgery takes about 30 minutes. People are going under the knife just to get dimples. And it cost over 400,000 naira. What do you think? This is like a normal thing? What is your take about this? Okay guys, that is where I'm going to hold it. I have to cut the news right here. Let me know what you think about this in the comment section below. It is very, very important, guys. Thank you guys for watching. And if you're just watching me for the first time, don't forget to subscribe. Like this video if you did enjoy this video. Until we see you next time.